I don't know if you guys ever hunt the big woods of PA, but if you look around at this landscape and the snow coming down, it's almost like a dream right here. This is what big buck hunters dream of.
They're dead. She's dead.
Yeah, let's go.
She's dead.
Oh,
she's
God.
Dead.
She's coming.
She's dead, baby. There's four. There's five.
I saw them run.
There's six, seven.
Oh, man. There's a lot of them. There's more. She's dead. She's rolling down there. All right, let's go. Dude, nice job.
Let's go.
Right here,
buddy.
Right here. Perfect.
Throwing this orange thing right on this branch here.
Okay.
And that's where we left. Where?
Yeah.
So there were seven more with that thing.
Yeah. We only saw two. No, we only saw three.
We saw one to start.
There they are. They're going up the other hillside.
All right, so we just shot that doe, and she went right down, but we left our stuff up here. I had popped up over the edge, and saw a deer standing down there. Had no shot, it was so thick with beech and laurel. And so we climbed back to the other side of the mountain and tried to swing back, come back around to this side to see him. And sure enough, there she was, still didn't have a shot. And ended up finding an opening that she walked through. It was the first deer that walked through that opening. And I said, when she walked through there, I'm squeezing it off. And I squeezed it off, she went right down, and seven more deer left with her. And then we're going to set up Herschel and see if we can get another one, because there's seven more. And we saw them climb the hill on the other side, all seven of them in a line. And they're going right in the thick stuff, and I'm gonna push that thick stuff right to them and hopefully get it done and double up today. Should be an awesome time.
Let's do it, let's double up. We got it.
Yeah.
That was quite an experience. Got you army crawling just through your pack.
Yeah. Yeah, through the pack. So get the camera. Let's go.
So, yeah, we started off seeing one.
Yep.
Ended up being seven or eight. Yeah. Seven or eight. So.
Yep.
I just froze. I can't talk.
Oh, well, the wind's hitting us right in the face. Let's go get this deer.
Let's go get him. I wasn't gonna get the deer. I wasn't gonna risk him seeing us. You shot it down. Oh, yep, there she is.
She's toast right there. Let's go to where I initially shot her at. Yeah, this is where I hit her. She's standing right here.
That's where I shot through.
We were on top of the hill right there.
And she crossed. Look at all this hair. All this hair. And then her trail goes right down through there.
Yeah. Yep.
She was standing right here.
Ended up right there.
Yeah. Look at that thing. Look how big that animal is. Maybe.
I think it did.
All right.
Yeah, that's a good deer right there.
Dude, last Saturday of deer season.
Last Saturday of deer season.
In Potter County while it's snowing. Look at it coming down.
It doesn't get much better than this, man.
Well, nice job.
Let's go. All right. Let's set her up for some. Well, it's the last Saturday of the Pennsylvania deer season, and I had one more tag for Potter County. It was a doe tag, and we got it done today. It is 8:15, and Herschel and I had walked up this point. It's about a mile walk to the top of this, and we were about 3/4 of the way. And I looked down one side. He was on the other side. I looked down the other. I saw this deer. Actually, I don't think it was this deer that I saw. I saw another deer, and it's like, man, I have no shot. But then, so we swung back around and got out around him, and I didn't have a shot still, so I dropped down into the ravine a little bit, and I had one opening. The first deer, the first doe that crosses that opening, I'm squeezing it off, and she went right down, and I shot at her again. I don't know if I hit her, but she died. I first shot her right up here, and then she slid down here and died. So it was really quick and clean, and it's a nice yearling doe, nice and tender. But we'll take what we can get here in Potter County. This is tough hunting, man. This is the steepest you'll ever find, and it's just beautiful. A lot of snow falling, and you just couldn't ask for anything better. Thanks for Herschel for filming, and also thank you to our grandpa for letting us come and use his camp. It's just been an awesome time for the last 12, 15 years, whatever it's been that we've been here. And just we've killed a lot of deer, and it's been a lot of fun, and the traditions continue to flow. So a lot of fun, and yeah, we're gonna get this thing gutted out, and we'll get her out of here, and another awesome day in the woods. EDO is on a roll. It is definitely in our blood. All right, so I killed my doe this morning, and I got her gutted, and I tagged her, and what I'm doing now is I'm going to be walking the other side of the ravine. Herschel's gonna be on one side, and I'm gonna bring the thick stuff right around to him. He still has a doe tag, so, and there were 7 deer with this doe, and I'm actually on their tracks right now, and I'm gonna follow them and just try to do a big loop and bring them right back to him. Awesome hunt, and it's just been an unbelievable year. I think that's 8 deer for us on film. Grant killed one yesterday in Tioga, so we're just hitting them real hard this year. This has been awesome, and it's just so beautiful out here. This is what we live for. This is absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, should go pretty easy because we're going all downhill and we got 2 guys.
Well, that's going to conclude our 2018 rifle season. What a year it's been so far. We're still not done. We have a couple tags left and we're going to try and hit them hard in muzzleloader season. So, but for now, we're putting the rifles away and the smoke poles are coming out. Man, what an awesome season, and we can't wait to get back in the woods here later in December. Awesome year. Hope you guys enjoyed it.